हेलो हेलो, माइक टेस्ट। कैन सी दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर कोड इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड थ्रू जस्ट अ फ्यू लाइंस एंड एन अमेजिंग सॉर्ट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन इज बीइंग एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम दिस स्मॉल कोड। Hello everyone, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're interested to get Indian stock market data in Python for free, then you're at the right place. In this video, we are going to explore an amazing API which extracts information from Bombay Stock Exchange, BSE, which is the most followed and the oldest stock exchange of India. If you're watching my video for the first time, guys, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here, I upload videos related to trading bots, things like implementation of AI in finance, or using some highly valuable finance APIs, etc., etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, a big shout out to my Patreon members, Edmund and the Pirate School. If you guys want to explore my Patreon community, then keep watching this video and I'll tell you about that in the end. The topics that we are going to cover today are, we'll talk about how to get Indian stock market data in Python. And this video is just focused on BSE. Next two videos will be focused on NSE, which is National Stock Exchange, another highly followed stock market exchange of India. So in this video, we'll talk about how to get quote of any particular stock. So we'll be using get quote function. Then we'll be using the same function for multiple companies. We'll get top gainers and top losers of any particular day. Then we'll be getting all this information using company tickers and multiple company tickers. So without any further ado, let's start writing our code. So this is the documentation that I can see of BSE data, and there are a lot of things here that we can follow, but the most important thing here is the documentation. I'll just click here and let's see what is inside the documentation that we have. So we have information about installing the BSE data library. Then we need to introduce it by providing a variable and then BSE. Then we can get the code, as I mentioned. This is the script code that we need to refer while getting the code, and all the companies have a different or unique script code. I'll be talking about this thing in some time, because this is something that we are not familiar with, and we definitely need to refer to some other file in order to get this information, because we are mostly familiar with that company ticker, but this is something that we need to get from some resource. We can see that VMart Retail has this particular code, right? Anyways, let's go ahead. For multiple companies, we can get this data, this information through just one for loop. Top gainers, top losers, getting indices. This is something that is not working in this API. Actually, I tried it before. There's some issue definitely, and that's why this particular function is not working. Then these are the script codes. This the entire update script codes. Using this particular function, we can get the entire list of all the script codes that I was talking about, the code that I mentioned in the beginning, for example this one. But again, this particular function is not working for some reason. Maybe like in future it will work, but I have a solution for that. No worries, this is to verify script code, and then in the end we can get the entire list of all companies and their script codes. Again, this all these functions are not working, but there's a solution that I have actually found, which is a different I would say Excel file that I get from this BSE India website. I'll be mentioning this thing in the description box down below. So what we need to do here is just click on that particular link and just select here equity status should be active, can belong to any group and any industry, and just submit. So you'll get the entire list of all the companies that are registered in BSE stock market. And what you need to do here is just click here. It will download a CSV file that we'll be referring in the code to get the script code, because like we are familiar with the tickers, which is security ID. Everyone or like all of us know what are tickers in Yahoo Finance or in any API that we use tickers. But here, for some reason, they are referring to the script code, which is absolutely fine. We'll have to refer to this particular CSV file where we'll be inputting the ticker value, and then that particular ticker will be mapped in this particular CSV to get the security code which will be used in the code that we'll be writing to extract all the information that we want. So this is something that I will work on. Now let's start writing our code. It starts with installing the BSE data, pip install BSE data. I'll just click here and control enter. Now from BSE data.bse, I'm importing BSE. Now B is equal to BSE. And if you write print B, you'll see driver class for Bombay Stock Exchange. Perfect. Now in order to get quote of any particular company. We just need to write B, which is this one. We have introduced it as BSE and then parenthesis and then dot get code. And then inside this, we want, we'll have to provide a script code. Right now, I've just provided, I would say, how hard coded it. Later, we will be referring it through the CSV file that we have downloaded, and we'll be referring that particular thing to get the script code. So these are all the information that we get. The 2 week average quantity, 52 week high, 52 week low, buy, sell, change, company name, and a lot of things. Industry, market capitalization, it's very important. Market cap is the information that is not available very freely. The change in performance and industry is also really, really important if you are doing any analysis. Now, if we want to get this particular thing for multiple companies, then in that case, we will have to use a for loop. So let's say the code list is these. There are two codes here, script codes that I'm actually providing. I'll just write for code in code list, and then I have provided quote is equal to b dot get code, and then inside that the code, which is the first one, and then after that it will come to the second one. I just want company name, company value, current value, and it was updated on what date. If I run this particular thing, we'll see one by one all these companies information will start coming. The first one is the IDBI Bank, and the second one is Avanti Feeds. You can see that the current value is 40.75, and it was last updated on 5th of August, 4 p.m. To get top gainers, you will have to write B dot top gainers with G capital, and you'll get all this information for the top gainers. You can see that the last trading price was this one of this particular company. You can see the security ID is this one, which is Philatex, and the script code is this one. Percentage change is 10.13% positive, and the total change was also 10.35. It's absolute change in the stock price, which is a big change, right? The second one is this one, Subex, and then all these things. Now there's one very important point. We are not familiar with both the security ID and the script code. Of course, we want company name, right? So in order to solve this problem, I have done something. So let me just quickly go through the top losers first, and then I'll come to that segment. Top losers is also similar to that one only. So B dot top losers, and you'll get all the information of top losers as well. Now let's see the file that we downloaded, right? So after clicking here, we download this particular file, and it has all the information that is required for us. So security code, which is very important. Then we have issuer name, security ID, security name, status, group, face value, ISIN number, industry, instrument, security name, industry, new name, group name, and subgroup name, right? I would have you can actually see that a lot of this information is not required at all. So I'll delete all the relevant information from this file. So I think, yeah, all this information is, I would say, are the only information that are important in my opinion. The first one is security code. Of course, we'll have to come to this particular code using the ticker names, right? So security ID is also important. Issuer name is important. There should be the name of the company that we are referring to. Industry, the sector name is very important in order to do some sector analysis. And in the end, we should be having ISIN number as well, because if, like, say, if in future we are integrating Bloomberg API, then in that case, we'll have to have some ISIN number as well. If you want to know more about the Bloomberg API in Python, then you can click on this particular video. I have actually provided all the information how to integrate Bloomberg API in Python to get all the data directly in Python. So from google.colab, import files and upload it, files.upload. This is how we upload any file in Google Colab. I'll just click this one, the file that I have downloaded. Some basic things, which is importing IO, importing pandas as PD, and the data is equal to io.bytes IO uploaded, which is the variable that I have introduced here, and then inside that file name, right? So pd.read.csv, this particular variable, which is data. If I click codes df, you can see the entire Excel file, the CSV file that I was referring to. Now suppose there all the tickers are INFI, which is Infosys, TCS, HDFC, ABB, and Birla Cable, then I want to know what are all the codes for this one particular. So I've actually just provided a basic for loop where for ticker and tickers, we are appending all the script codes in this particular list, which is codes. And you can see it's basically, what I'm doing here is just basically providing some filter here and getting the security code. We just write codes here, you'll get the entire list of all the codes here. Let me just go above, copy this one, the entire thing that I've written, paste this thing again, and rather than this for code and code list, I'll just replace it with codes, and we'll get the entire all this information for all these five companies. So this is how we can actually get all the I would say required information using ticker names as well. We are not at all required to remember these particular codes, because we can definitely extract it using the CSV file that we downloaded from the BSC India Data website. Now guys, if you want all these things as a product for yourself, actually I have written the entire code with very easy step-by-step procedure, which is this one. So basically what I have done here is I have written all these things. You just need to upload the equity to file which we downloaded from the BSC India website. You can see that in top gainers I have actually provided some more things here. If I go back here, you'll see that in top gainers you had a very limited information, which is LTP, change, percentage change, script code, and script security ID. We didn't know about the company name. So what I've done here is I have apart from these four things, I have extracted the company name as well, the security ID, the sector name and IC number here from the equity file that we downloaded from the BSC India website. And similar to that, in losers as well, I have the top losers as well, I have actually provided all these information. So you just need to run this and you'll get all this information. And again, yeah, here as well, like I have added all the relevant information, important information from that particular CSV file here, and it will get all the information of all the tickers that we provide here. So in this case, as we already know, we are providing five different tickers here: Infi, TCS, HDFC, ABB, and Birla Cable. And you'll see that this small few lines of codes will actually give you information about all relevant information about these particular companies, which is 52 week high, 52 week low, market capitalization, which is very important, percentage change, previous price, price, industry, and the name. So you can see that this particular code is constructed through just a few lines, and an amazing sort of information is being extracted from this small code. You can find this code, guys, in my Google Drive. All my already existing subscribers know that I share my Google Drive access for free to all my subscribers. What you need to do here is just click on access to my Google Drive button. Just follow some basic steps, and then over there, just click on the Google form. Again, just follow some, just provide some basic information, and I'll be using this email address to provide a free access of my Google Drive. And this particular code will be saved in the Google Drive. And not only this code, there are many more codes that are saved in that particular Google Drive, including my trading bots. Everything is free of cost. You just need to be my subscriber. And also, one lucky subscriber will get a chance of a one-on-one free consultation that I do on a monthly basis. If you're still watching my video, then please hit on the like button. It's really, really important for the algorithm, the YouTube algorithm. And also just write on the comment section what more information you wanted me to include in this particular video. Any specific recommendation that you want me to cover in future, please write it on the comment box. And if you want to explore my Patreon community, it's very, very affordable. And these are all the services that I provide on my Patreon community. And this is how you'll be supporting me as well. So I highly appreciate all your support over there. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And over there, you can see how I used AlphaVantage API to extract some US listed companies information. And over there, you can see how I use TradingView to do some crazy things like making a trading strategy, etc. Stay tuned, and I'll see you very, very soon. Thank you so much.